But first tonight, Sydney is sweltering through its hottest day so far this year.
And this is just the beginning of what could be a record-breaking sequence. It started relatively mild, but the mercury continued to rise through the morning. By 9 o'clock, office workers were dashing for the air conditioning. Temperatures pushing 30 degrees. By lunchtime, 32 in the city, 36 in the west. And by 3 o'clock this afternoon, the temperatures had passed the dreaded 40-degree mark in the west.
Right now, it is 32 degrees in the city where John Hill joins us. And first, Gabby Boyle, though, at Homebush, where the mercury remains above 40 degrees.
Well, Gabby, the pools are the place to be today. And what are they doing?
Well, Bill, I have spent a day in Sydney's searing west. The heat is absolutely incredible. The sun is relentless. There is barely a breeze. Hundreds have turned out here at Sydney Olympic Park to take a dip. Let me tell you, after this live cross, I'll be tempted to jump in and join them. It is absolutely stifling out here. Here's a little of how Sydney suffered through the heat today.
Penrith Pool was where all the cool kids were at today.
Sometimes they get a little bit feral because it's hot and they get hot, we get hot. So it's just nice being able to just bring them to the pool and chill out and, yeah, it's good.
And the perfect place to spend a hot day at the pool?
Oh, definitely. It's the only place to go. We're so far away from the beach, so, yeah, it's the only place to come, really. Yeah.
No matter where you were, everyone was roasting.
It's very hot. It's swimming.
In the searing sun, lawn bowls wasn't exactly a choice way to spend the day, nor was sunbaking beside the empty Campbelltown pool, which is currently being upgraded. Poor air quality coupled with temperatures of over 40 degrees, and ambulance officers responded to several heat-related call-outs.
The longer you go with prolonged heat without much relief, the more problematic it is for people who are susceptible to heat.
Yeah, everyone's pretty much staying inside at the moment, keeping out of the heat.
In the city, sporting a suit was nothing short of sweaty. Beachside was the very best place to be, and an ice cream was the flavour of the day. Even the animals at Taronga Zoo got a frosty treat, a very cool spectacle for visitors to the zoo. Gabrielle Boyle, 10 News.
Well, John Hill is with commuters in the city and very sensibly has gotten rid of his suit jacket. John, this could be a very uncomfortable journey home tonight. How are people trying to keep cool?
Well, Deb, still pretty hot here in the city, although I noticed in the last half hour, you mentioned in the opener 32 degrees here, that heat has backed off with a little bit of a breeze. It seems people have dressed for the occasion. They knew it was going to be a hot day, so they've dressed appropriately. There aren't too many jackets or, in fact, too many ties. Now, that commute home, I've had a check of some of these state transit buses. The newer ones, the drivers say, are much, much cooler. The older ones, they're some as old as 20 years old. The air conditioning didn't seem to be working on those, so I suspect it's going to be a hot and sweaty trip for some people on buses tonight. As for the trains, we know from the Waratah train problems, the government has told us only 70% of trains have air conditioning. Spare a thought for everybody else in those 30% of trains with no cooling at all. They'll certainly be roasting. But take a look at this. We went down to Town Hall Station where they're trialling misting fans, only on one platform and only a trial. But I've got to say, it was the most popular place on that platform. Certainly very cool for those lucky people. There may be misting fans at your station sometime soon. The people who were taking advantage of that were very happy. Here's what some of them had to say.
Yeah, they're great. Great idea. Especially with this weather we're having, it's just nice to chill out before you hop on the train.
So I've been stuck here for a while, so yeah, it's helped.
Now, what about travelling home on the trains tonight? I mean, depending on whether you got a train with air conditioning or not, it could be a nice ride or it could be a hill.
It could be a bloody disaster, yeah.
Well, let's hope it will be a cooler day tomorrow and a cooler commute for everybody concerned. Deb?
Let's hope so. Thank you, John Hill there in the CBD.